Hi, I'm John Riley. Very happy to be joined by my good friend, Mr. Paul Francis, master cymbal maker from Zildjian, here at the Memphis Drum Shop. And we'd like to talk about the Zildjian Swish Knocker. This is a Chinese cymbal, and this cymbal was Mel Lewis's cymbal. And people are really confused about what this cymbal is, whether it's a death crash that you play at the loudest moment to try and shock the band members or the audience. But actually, this is considered a ride cymbal. And I first heard Mel Lewis playing it in 1972 when I was a student at North Texas. And I wasn't really familiar with this sound very much. And I heard him describe what he looked for in a cymbal like this. And he said, well, if you go in a shop and there's a couple of them, just tap them with your finger. And he said, look for the one that sustains the longest. And then play that and see if you can hear a definite stick sound. He said you want it to sound like caw, 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 caw. And in an ensemble, it's traditionally, in a big band, it's traditionally used behind the strongest soloist in the band because it's a complex sound. It's a kind of big sound. And we use it during strong sections, but the trick is, because it's a loud cymbal, even though you're playing it during the loud sections, you're not playing it quite as hard as the other cymbals. So you get this big sound with a lighter touch. And I think Mel Lewis was introduced to this sound by Dizzy Gillespie. And I had the opportunity to play with Dizzy, and he had a Chinese cymbal in the main ride cymbal position. I was playing with him on Mickey Roker's drums, and Mickey had the regular ride cymbal here and the Chinese cymbal here. And I was playing on the regular ride cymbal, and Dizzy points to the Chinese cymbal. So I went to that, and then he smiled. And the second song, I'm playing on the regular ride cymbal. This Chinese cymbal is scaring me, but he points to it again, and I play that. And after the gig, I asked him, why do you like the Chinese cymbal? And he said, well, I play trumpet. People think of that as a bright sounding instrument. But he said, I feel like I have a dark sound. And when the drummer plays on the regular cymbal, my sound doesn't project. But when the drummer plays on a darker, lower pitched cymbal, then it feels like my sound carries and it makes it feel easier for me to play. And there's been some demand for this kind of cymbal. It was sort of in and out of fashion. And a couple of years ago, Paul and I were discussing it, and I sent him the cymbal to the factory in Boston, and he made some amazing replicas of them. Would you speak about that process?
Sure. So, like you were saying, this is a very, very unique cymbal. And if you look at it, it doesn't have the traditional curvature of some Chinese cymbals. It's very high. It's almost like a triangular shape from the base of the bell to the start of the lip, and then the lip starts, and it has a nice curve in the flange, but it's not really curved so much that you don't get that low crash and that long sustain. So because the way of that this one was specifically made, it's ultra unique because we had a stack of them at the factory from this era, and none of them were the same. So in order to get this sound that was made famous by Mel Lewis, we had tooling made up. So every time that we make a new Swish Knocker, it's very, very similar. It's not identical. That's nearly impossible to do. But it has very similar sound characteristics to this one here. And you get that caw sound that you're looking for. And it also comes installed with 20 rivets, so you get this long sustain when you're riding it or when you have the crash. So you can, this is exactly this shape when you buy it from Zildjian now. It's the Mel Lewis shape from the Vanguard.
Yeah, this one is kind of special because in the factory, when they found a really good cymbal in the old days, often they had this sort of ink stamp like you would have in the post office, and they would stamp on the cymbal mother, meaning this was a really good one, and this really faintly has this little mother stamp.
Yep.
I remember the first time I brought it up to the factory, and you said, does it have the mother stamp on it?
Yeah, that's right, that's right.
And they're kind of tricky to play, but there's a place for them in music, and some band leaders that I work with ask specifically, are you going to bring the Chinese cymbal?
Yeah.
You know, so that's it's an old sound. You listen to the very earliest jazz drummers, and often they had small Chinese cymbals that were effect cymbals,
right.
And it's grown into more or less a ride cymbal. And I'm really happy to have that kind of color in my sound palette.
And you can have that sound color too in your palette, because Zildjian is continuing to make it.
Well, maybe I'll play them both. Is that okay?
John, let's hear you play them.